What's going on, 2020 family? Today, I want to start off today's cast with a quote from Abilene Clark. That's a character played by Viola Davis in the movie The Help. And she said, "You is kind, you is smart, you is important."
Mama, I just wanna sing. Mama said, according to get everything, you gotta risk everything. So I'm smoking my Kush, reading Corinthians. Smoking my Kush, reading Corinthians. Smoking my Kush, reading Corinthians. Smoking my Kush, reading Corinthians.
Yeah, we here. What's good, y'all? This is the 2020 Vision Podcast. I am Mike Chuck 1212, and I'm back in the building on a special episode today. It's Mother's Day, y'all. It's Mother's Day Sunday, first of all, we definitely want to get a shout out to all of the all the mothers, single, married, in a relationship, what have you. I want to give a special shout out to all the mothers. Happy Mother's Day to all of y'all. always recognize that the mother, this is just my opinion, but I think it's, I definitely think it's the truth. The mother is the initial teacher of everything. The mother is the primary teacher. And it's not necessarily the way it should be, but it's the way it is. So take care of your motherhood, because y'all are really, really special people. And you're probably the most important people on the earth. So we definitely want to give y'all a big, big shout out. Once again, happy Mother's Day. Shout out to all y'all. Love all y'all. So the first thing I want to cover real quick. I really just want to not let anyone forget about the young man in that was murdered in cold blood by police in Ball Springs, Texas. Young Jordan Edwards. He doesn't have an opportunity to wish his mother happy Mother's Day today. He doesn't have that opportunity like the rest of us do. So I definitely want to take some time out today, and I would like for everybody else to take some time out today and just reflect on this young man. He was 15 years old, and I read a great deal about him the day after the situation. All of his teachers, people close to the family, everybody, neighbors, everybody unanimously said that, you know, this was a good kid. He wasn't a troublemaker, not in the least. He was close to a straight A student. I believe I read that he had a 3.5 GPA. He had a legitimate future. Okay, he the ceiling for this young man was very, very high. It was in the clouds somewhere, and he was taken away from those closest to him all too soon, because we still have an issue in this country with scary white men being police officers and being scary white men and policing at the same time. That's a very, very sad case. It was first reported that the car he was in was aggressively driving towards a police officer. They recanted that story the very, very next day and said that the car that Jordan Edwards was in was driving away from the police officer very fast. I also want to point out that Jordan Edwards was in the passenger seat. He was not a driver. I also want to point out that Jordan Edwards was shot with a rifle to his head. Now, I don't know much about being a police officer. I know a lot about carrying a gun. I know a lot about shooting a gun. I don't know much about being a police officer, but what I do know is that I've never seen a police officer with a rifle. I've never seen a police officer with a shotgun. I've never seen any of that. I'm not seeing any of that outside of a movie. Okay. So first of all, Jordan Edwards was shot with a rifle. He was shot with an assault rifle. Why was he shot with a fucking assault rifle? Why? That in itself is a question that just needs to be answered. It needs to be answered. Why was he shot with a rifle? On top of that, for a while, I haven't even checked because it's weird how this stuff happens and we just let the story die down. But I haven't even checked, but, you know, they still had the kids with him. They still had them in custody after he was killed. It's blood all in the car. It's probably brains all over the place because, like I said, he got shot in the head. Those kids are probably traumatized, and they're going to be traumatized for the rest of their lives. but once again, it's because of some scared white man, you know what I'm saying, scared of black people. And, you know, let me stop that. It wasn't because he was a scared white man. This was a guy who he was shooting at birds, basically. He saw a car driving away with some black kids in it, and he shot into it. He was really trying to murder someone. And they recently brought him up on charges for murder. Now, I don't agree with the fact that they fired him and they brought him up on charges for murder. But he got out on bond. Like, there's no bond in a murder case. Like, well, at least where I'm from, black folks ain't getting no fucking bond. We ain't getting no bond for a drug case, let alone murder. But that's a different story entirely. I'm not trying to get into all that and be, you know what I'm saying, be activist Chuck right now. I'm just, you know what I'm saying, I just want to make sure that we don't forget this young man and his mother and his family, because he's 15. He was 15. He done had the opportunity to say Happy Mother's Day. And I guarantee that his mom feels that right now. I guarantee she does. I guarantee she feels it every single day. The fact that her son got murdered in cold blood by police, by people that were supposed to be protecting her son as opposed to killing him. So I guarantee she feels that every day. So some part of me wants all of Black America to feel it every day. You know, I had a conversation with a close friend and, yo, I cried. I can't even front. I shed tears at the fact that, you know, we Black Americans are so caught up in what, you know what I'm saying, what Stevie J and Jocelyn and Bonnie Bella got going on. And we so caught up in Black Ink New York and Real Housewives of Atlanta and Phaedra and Candy and whatnot. We're so caught up in that shit. And we forget about the real facts of life and the real aspects of America and the real things that are going on. And, you know, I shed tears because, you know, I'm looking at my timeline, you know, in a time frame where I see how, you know, how, like, true to life prevalent this situation with Jordan Edwards is. It just hurt me to my soul that I felt like nobody was paying attention. You know, I can and come to think of it, I can jump on Snapchat and post a thirst trap or post a picture of myself and, you know, talk about how good I look. Everybody's going to respond to it. Throw it on Instagram. Everybody's going to respond to it. You know what I'm saying? Hundreds of likes. And then I post something where, you know what I'm saying, people really should take a look at it. People should really be listening to what I'm saying. It's really, really interesting and real shit. Nobody pays attention to it. It's almost as if, like, we want to eat the bullshit in our lives. It's the difference in between, you know, eating healthy and eating fucked up. Like, I guess the drama and the bullshit in life is like baking the eggs with salt and pepper and hot sauce and toast and I don't know. That's a good meal for me. If it's not a good meal for you, I'm sorry. But I guess that's the difference between, you know what I'm saying, that and then turkey bacon and egg whites and wheat bread. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? But it just seems as if we want to eat the bullshit. We don't want to be healthy. We don't want to have healthy minds and healthy lives. We just want to be, you know, we don't want to see what goes on in the world every day. And we don't want to be a part of the solution to what goes on in the world every day. And that's a sad situation. You know, I don't have any kids right now. And, you know, I refuse to bring kids into a world where I'm not a part of trying to make this world better. You know what I'm saying? How can I teach my kids anything without teaching them, you know, when you see a problem, if you can help fix that problem, you should be helping to fix that problem. How can I have kids without doing that? But I know I'm going to say that. You know what I mean? I can't be a do as I say, not as I do parent. You know what I'm saying? I want you to do as I do. So I'm trying to be the best person I can be before, you know what I'm saying, I bring kids to this world. And I'm trying to help make this world as good as I can beforehand as well. That's the most important thing. But once again, it is Mother's Day. It is Mother's Day. And I want to shout out some very, very special mothers in my life that have really impacted my life and me as a man. And even when I was a child, you know, they really helped me become who I am. First and foremost, I'm definitely going to shout out my own mother, Brenda Faye Young. So just a little about my mom. My mom is from the South End, Little Rock, Arkansas. I'm pretty sure most of y'all are familiar with the South End. And her father and mother both come from, well, her father comes from, his family comes from Greenville, Mississippi. My mother is probably like, well, she's one of the strongest women I know. She gave birth to 4 kids, 3 boys, 1 daughter. And we all got big ass heads. You know what I'm saying? She pushed all of us out. no C-section. But my mom is strictly business. You know what I mean? And I admire that part about her because, you know, when you see my mom, everybody's going to be like, dang, she look mean. But she's not mean. She just, you know, she's one of those people that, you know, let me look like this so motherfuckers won't test me. You know what I'm saying? That's my mom. And, like, she's a really, really strong lady. And she's smart. That's pretty much where, you know, the me and my siblings, we gain our intelligence from is from my mom. Like, not that she taught us a great deal, but she taught us to seek knowledge, if you will. She made us read, and she made us read certain types of things. Like, we read, you know, we read The Hobbit and The Lord of the Rings. We had to read Robin Hood, you know. We read books about the KGB and the USSR. We read interesting stuff when I was a young kid. And so it's got a lot to do with why, you know what I'm saying, my mind works the way it does. So my mom was a very intelligent lady. She was a real strong lady. And she was real caring, you know what I'm saying? She saved us from a lot of whoopings from my dad when I was coming up. She saved us from a lot of whoopings from my pops coming up, you know. So shout out first and foremost to my mom. The second mother I want to shout out is my sister, Colette Young. My sister, Colette, is probably, you know what I'm saying, she got a little attitude, you know, but she just like me. And she one of the sweetest people I know, you know what I mean? And I'm not saying that because she's my sister. She genuinely is one of those people, like, she'll walk around with no shirt on to give you the shirt off her back to make sure you got a shirt. You feel what I'm saying? Like, if she go to the store and get, you know, get a box of ramen noodles or something, she going to give me half so I can eat. You know what I'm saying? I honestly, like, I believe my mom and dad just went to Little Rock yesterday, and they're spending today with my sister and her kids. And I guarantee that my sister is either today or tomorrow, she's getting some food together and she's going to send my mom and dad back with some food to give to me. I already know it. That's